The snow thickened and became heavier, and she had to hurry before the tunnel of snow turned to ice. She had no idea what direction she was going in. Would she be able to find her way back at all? Tiredness overcame her, and soon she couldn't stand upright any longer. She had to shuffle along on all fours in the dark, a little bit at a time. I may as well stay here and freeze to death. I'm never going to make it home, she thought. But just as she was about to close her eyes and lie down, she heard a scratching, scraping sound somewhere in the snow in front of her. The sound came closer. Something was sniffing and digging its way along towards Thumbelina, and suddenly a nose appeared out of the snow. Hello? Are you lost? I think I am, replied Thumbelina, who was so cold and weak that she could hardly speak. Come home with me then, so you can get warm. She saw now that it was a mouse that had come to save her. The mouse had had a feeling that someone was in danger outside its nest, so it had made its way out to check, and now it showed her the way to its abode in a tree root nearby. The snow swirled, and the mouse quickly opened the door to let Thumbelina in. Inside, a fire crackled, and there was a bowl of hot soup on the table and some bread and cheese. You could probably do with some food, little girl. Get warm in front of the fire, and then you'll get something to eat. Thanks, dear kind mouse. You saved my life, said Thumbelina, rubbing her toes, which had started to thaw out. Once her clothes had dried, Thumbelina felt warmer, and she ate till she was full and sleepy. The mouse showed her a bed where she could sleep till the next day.